So I welcome every participant in this meet. So we are bringing you the best course on aviation personality development and soft skills by one and only former international cabin crew, Richa Maheshwar. So in this course, you will be going to learn more about personality development skills, communication skills, and many of that. So all over to you, Richa.
Well, thank you, Manbir, for the kind introduction. Hi, everyone. Hi, Mayuri. Hi, Subrat. Hi, Bhargav. How are you all doing?
Hello.
Hi, Subrat.
I'm great. How about you?
Very well. Thank you. Can I request all of you all to put your cameras on? It's nice to see you all. It's nice to interact with you when you have your cameras on. Otherwise, it's like talking to your profile pictures, which is not very exciting. So can I request everyone to please have their cameras on? Mayuri, Bhargav, and Subrat.
No, actually, there is a power cut in my area, so there's a little inconvenience.
No worries. Whoever can put it on, please do that. Thank you, Bhargav. How are you doing? Bhargav, are you able to hear me? Okay. I'm not sure if we are able to hear you. And Mayuri, how about you? Can I request you to put your camera on? It'll be nice to see you and interact with you, looking at you. You know, virtual platforms have become very, technologically they're very advanced, but you still need to see people, you know, face to face to interact with them, right? Okay. So, Subrat, I've already spoken to you before. Bhargav, I believe we have not interacted before. Can you tell me a little bit about yourself, please? So I hold an aviation background. I've flown with two of the international airlines way back in 2005. I flew with Kingfisher Airlines for about 2.5 years. And then I flew with Indigo for another 2.5 years. So total of 5 years of experience as a cabin crew. I have about 12 years of experience into training. After I quit airlines, I got into corporate training. I am very fond of and very passionate about empowering and transforming lives of people. I love to help people develop their personality. I love to help them understand what their challenges are, what their issues are, and how they can work and overcome on those challenges. I'm somebody who's very self-motivated. I'm somebody who's very positive by nature. I love to help people. I love to empower people. And in my free time, I like to, do a little bit of cooking, and I love to read. I love to listen to music, love to dance. That's what is a little bit about myself. All right. So that's about me, and welcome to the course of personality development and soft skills in aviation. Bhargav, if you can use the chat box to communicate, that would be great because we are not able to hear you. But whenever there are anything that you want to ask or anything at all, please put it in the chat box. Okay. So we are going to use very interactive means, though this is a virtual platform. I want everyone, all of us, to be very, very participative. It should not just be me talking. It has to be all of you interacting, asking questions, getting your doubts cleared, everything. Okay. So let's make it an interactive session. Yes. Can you all please smile and let's have that energy level. Come on, everyone. Yeah. All right. So let's get started with our session. I'm going to share my screen, and here we go. All right. Okay, so we've already introduced ourselves. Now let's quickly go on to the rules for the session. What are the rules going to be? I want everyone to participate actively. Please make your notes. Whatever we are going to talk about, we are not giving you any handouts as such. So please jot down those points in your notebooks. Do this for your own good. It's not something which will help anybody else but yourself. So do this for your own good. Mind your posture during the session. Sit up straight, back straight. And I hope everyone has had a good breakfast before joining in the session. So make sure that you are posture is absolutely all right. Your body language is good. We will clap for each other. We will, you know, whenever somebody gives a good answer, let's applaud each other. We will adhere to the timelines. The session starts from 10 o'clock in the morning till 11:30 on all the 5 days, that is starting from Monday to Friday. So let's come on time during the session and end the session on time. Of course, you're free to ask questions even after the session. That's absolutely all right. And let's make sure that our cell phones, which are the major distractors today, our phones are kept away and they are on silent mode. Are we good to go? Please give me a thumbs up in the chat box. Please let me know if the rules are okay with you or are they too much for you? Let me know what you feel about the rules. Thank you, Mayuri. Yeah, if you feel you want to add some more rules, please go ahead and do that. Okay, all right. So please use the chat box as much as you can to communicate, and also you can unmute and speak whenever you feel like, all right? All right, moving on from here. Before we start our session, I want to ask you, why are you here? In the sense, why is each person of you over here? What is it that you want to take away from here? Takeaway means not McDonald's ka takeaway. Takeaway means what is your expectation from the session and why you have come over here to in this aviation course of soft skills and personality. So I'm going to start with Suvrat, do you want to tell us why are you here? What are you here to learn?
Okay, so basically it's on internet. So I found a place where I can learn these things, and why not?
Okay, all right. Great. So how to develop a dynamic personality which will help you in any field, is that why you are here, right?
Yes.
Fantastic. All right. Thanks for sharing that, Suvrat. Over to you, Bhargav. Can you tell us why are you here? What is it that you want to learn in our session today? Can't hear you, my dear. Use the chat box, Bhargav. There is some issue, I think, of voice from your end. Just use the chat box. All right. So while Bhargav is typing in his answer, let's move on to Mayuri. Mayuri, why are you here? What brings you here to our session, Mayuri? You can unmute and speak, or you can put it in the chat box, please. Okay, so Mayuri says interest in the job role at this particular organization. All right, so getting a job in this organization is what your interest level is, and that's why you have joined the course. Fantastic. Anything else apart from that? Bhargav, I'm looking at your answer also. Just type in whenever you can, okay? All right, good. So we are all here because we want to know why do some people have a good personality and why they are able to shine, why they are able to have such a charming and dynamic personality while others are not, right? So this is a skill which some people are born with, some people can learn it, but moreover, more than anything, it's something that, you feel that kind of magnetic pull towards someone when you have that kind of a personality, you know. So everybody, all of us look up to some or the other leader or some or the other great personality. They can be from the field of sports, they can be from politics, they can be from the Hollywood industry, whoever. So I want to ask you, what is that personality whom you look up to? Whom do you feel, you know, that, oh, wow, I want to be like this person, or I want to have a personality of this guy or this person, this girl, whoever. So can you tell me who do you look up to? Which personality figure is your favorite? Suvrat?
Yes, ma'am. I look up to Ratan Tata. Very frequently.
Great. And why is the reason? Why do you feel he has a great personality? What is it about him that really makes you like him?
Basically, his aura. Whenever he speaks or he walks, or the way he sits and conveys things.
Yeah.
It's very, you know, charming kind of thing to watch Ratan Tata.
Fantastic. Great answer, Suvrat. So yes, the way he walks, talks, the way he sits down, his body language, the way he speaks, all of this is something that makes you look up to him as a personality, right, Suvrat?
Yes.
That's great. Fantastic. Okay. So Mayuri says, Mr. APJ Abdul Kalam, very good, great personality. And why do you like him, Mayuri? What makes you look up to him as a personality? Just give me a second. I'm just reading the chat. Okay, so Bhargav says you want to know about the industry platform and how things are from in a real world. Okay, you don't have any. Okay, you're from Australia. Great. So, great. Thanks for sharing that, Bhargav. So I like to make the course very, very interactive. And that's the reason I'm going to keep asking you all, keep drilling you all with questions. I hope that is okay with you all. Okay, because I don't like to keep on talking. I like to make my session such that the participants get to interact, talk, and all that. Hope that's good. Give me a thumbs up in the chat box if you are okay with that. Okay. All right. Thank you. Great. So what is it about the other person that makes you feel that you want to look up to them, you follow them, they are influencers in your life because of their personality? Like I always say in all my training sessions, your first impression is your last impression. And you know how much time does it take to create a first impression? Any idea? How much time does it take? How many minutes, how many seconds, or how many hours does it take to make a good impression on somebody? Any idea? How soon can you make an impression on someone? First impression is the last impression. So how much time does it take for anybody to make an impression on somebody? So nobody is answering, let me give you the answer. It takes only 7 seconds, friends. Yes, you heard me right. 7 seconds to make or break an impression. And in 7 seconds, when you meet somebody for the first time, be it at a job interview or be it for a meeting, in 7 seconds, how can you make a good impression on people? It is only with the way of how you dress up, how you carry yourself, how you speak, your personality, the way you do a handshake. These are small, small things, but they make such a big difference. You know, your etiquette, your manners comes out in these 5 to 7 seconds, okay? The way you carry yourself. So, you know, it's like if you're in a room full of people and if there's a great personality who walks in through the door, everybody eyes turns on to that person. Why? Because of the way they carry themselves, the way they dress up, the way their body language is, you know? So that charm, that personality is something which all of us can learn, and that's what we are here to teach you. How to make a good impression on people, how to make a sustainable and a consistent and a lasting impression on people. Okay, so 7 seconds is what it takes. Your first impression is the last impression, and you have to be very careful about this. Okay, especially when you go for a job interview. We'll talk about that later during our session, but in our session we're going to learn all of these things: your grooming, your presentation skills, your body language, your communication, the way you present yourself. These are what we are going to cover in these 5 days of this particular course. Okay, and of course, as and when you have any questions, doubts, you can keep asking me. I'll try and answer it to the best of my ability. All right. Okay, so I want you all to do a small test right now. Okay, we are back in school. Are we asking you all to do a test? Okay, let me see if you all can. I'll just share my screen. Okay, there is a website which I would like you all to go to and fill up a personality test. Okay, so I'm going to share that link right now with you in the chat box. I hope everyone has a good, if you have a good Wi-Fi connection, you all can immediately log into that and do this particular test. There are a couple of questions which you have to answer. Don't take too much of time to answer those questions. The first thing which comes to your mind, you have to answer it like that. Okay, so let me share that with you. Okay, I put the link in the chat box. Please download this, not download it. I mean, just go to this particular link and fill up a personality test. It'll hardly take you about 5 or 6 minutes, I think. Okay, and once you're done, just drop me a text saying that you have finished the test. Okay, any questions you all can ask me. Mayuri, I didn't understand what you're saying. Link not yet meaning? I've already put it into the chat box. See if you all can see it, everyone. So, Vrat, Bhargav, Mayuri, can you all see the link in the chat box?
Oh, no, ma'am. The link is not visible.
Okay. I think I've sent it to... okay, hold on, please. Okay, now I guess everybody would be able to see the link. Yes, everyone, you all can see the link. Please start filling up this questionnaire, this test on personality. Okay, 3 more minutes to go. Try and finish it during this 3 minutes. Okay, have you all finished the test? Please put it in the chat box if you have, or if you still need more time. Bhargav, Suvrat, Mayuri, how many of you have finished the test? Okay.
Yes, ma'am, I've done.
Who's that, Suvrat?
Yes.
Okay, you have finished. How about, okay, Mayuri, you have also done. How about you, Bhargav? Bhargav, if you finished doing the test, please put it in the chat box. Okay, so most of you have finished, and we have some new participants who have just joined us in the session. I believe, Manveer, are they from your team, or there are a few people who've joined in? Could you just check on that? If they're from your team, or if...
Well, they are from our team.
They are from your team, right? So Umang, and they're from your team, right? Because if they are participants, then I need to quickly
Umang
add them.
Umang is participant and Mezba is from our team.
Okay, so let's have Umang. Thanks for telling me that, Manvi. Umang, can I request you to introduce yourself? You've come in a little late today, which will not be allowed from tomorrow. So quickly introduce yourself to everyone over here, Umang. Okay, great, Umang. Bhargav, you've completed the test. All right. Umang, you are a student. Umang, is it possible to unmute yourself and talk a little bit about yourself to all the participants? And also, if you can just, enable your video, it'll be nice to see you during the session. If it's possible, turn on your video. If not, it's okay. All right. So all of you who have just undergone the test, Mayuri, Bhargav, and Suvrat, you must have got a particular personality type, right? Yeah?
Yes.
So Suvrat, what was your personality type which came out on the screen?
Protagonist.
Okay. How about you, Bhargav? And Mayuri, what were your personality types which came out? You can put it into the chat box. Okay. So basically why we have done this test, it is to know, so these tests are not completely accurate. It depends on how you have answered the question, whether you've been completely honest with yourself when you're answering. So there are 16 types of different personality. Most of us know that there are only two types of personality, extrovert and introvert. Right, most of us feel ki personality bole to ya to aap bahut outgoing hai, you are very social, very extrovert kind of a person, or you're somebody who's a little introvert who keeps to himself or herself, right? So but research shows us that there are so many different kind of personalities. So this is just to give you an idea that once you come to know yourself better, you are able to outshine, and you're able to have that kind of personality when you yourself believe and accept yourself the way we are. Okay, a lot of times we have issues accepting us the way we are. We feel we should have been more smarter, we should have been more good looking, or we should have been more having great communication skills by like the other person. So we compare ourselves with others, and we have a little low self-esteem, and we have a little less of self-confidence, which is not a good thing. Okay, we should not judge ourselves. We should just accept us the way we are. And that's very important if you want to have a good personality. Now, people who are great leaders in life, leaders, when I say leaders, it can be from any industry, any field. people who are leaders today, they are successful leaders. Why? Because they have accepted them. They have that confidence in themselves. They have accepted their challenges, their weaknesses, whatever it is. And they have worked on themselves. And that's why today they are at a position of leadership. Okay. So what I'm trying to tell you all, friends over here, is that we have to really work on ourselves internally first so that we are able to shine outwardly. Make sense? Everybody, please put your answers in the chat box if you agree to this or if you are in acceptance of this or not. Put it in the chat box. All right. Thank you, Mayuri. Thank you, Subrat. Fantastic. So what I'm going to do now is just share my screen and tell you all a little bit about what is personality. Okay. So let me do that. Okay, so what do you mean by personality development? Let me share my screen completely so that you're able to see it. So what do you mean by personality development? Personality traits are enduring patterns of perceiving, relating to, and thinking about the environment and oneself, and are exhibited in a wide range of important social and personality contexts. See, the way you think, the way you behave, the way your thoughts are, and the way you interact with others is all about your personality. So the way you think, your feelings, your emotions, that's all combined together as what is personality. Okay, now what is this personality? How does it form? Anybody? Anybody has an idea? Where do you get this personality from? Put your answers in the chat box. Mayuri, what do you feel? How do you get this personality? How does it come into picture? कैसे होता है पर्सनालिटी क्या होता है मतलब वी हैव अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज पर्सनालिटी बट हाउ डज इट व्हाट डू आई से हाउ डज इट यू नो कम फोर्थ व्हाट गोज इनटू मेकिंग योर पर्सनालिटी एनीबॉडी
आई थिंक पर्सनालिटी इज अ रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ व्हाट वी ग्रास्प फ्रॉम आवर सराउंडिंग्स
Very good, Subrat. Yes, what we grasp from our surrounding, that's one aspect of personality. The environment you have grown up in, you know, when you were a small child, you know, till the time of 7 years, till the child is 7 years old, or rather, I think 6 years old, your subconscious mind is so strong that whatever is happening around you, you gain from those things. It starts affecting you. Okay. So if you've grown up in a broken home, for example, okay, or if you've grown up in a family where there were a lot of fights and where there were a lot of conflicts were there, somewhere it impacts your personality. All right. Likewise, if you've grown up in a surrounding or in an environment at home where your parents were very loving towards each other, or there was always a lot of positivity around. So then what happens? It helps you to shape your personality in that particular way or manner. So to a large extent, our personality is determined by our surroundings, our genetics. Yes, our environment. These all play a very, very crucial role in your developing of your personality. Now, aisa nahi hai ki personality ek bar form ho gaya, you cannot change it or you can't work on it. Aisa nahi hai, okay? You can definitely throughout your life, you can work on your personality. It's something which which you work on with a lot of hard work and consistency, you can actually change your personality for the better. Okay. So that is what I wanted to share with you all on personality. It's all about the way you think, the way your mind works, the way you perceive things in a particular way. That's all these things go into making of a personality. All right. Now let me share. Any questions so far? Anybody? Please feel free to ask. Any questions? Okay. Whenever you all have any doubts, please don't hesitate. I would just want you all to get your doubts clear. Don't think anything much about it. What will people think? How can I ask such a stupid question? Don't think all of those things. Okay. Please go ahead and ask your questions. Okay. Okay. Let me quickly share my screen. So now in an iceberg, all of you have seen an iceberg. Agar real life mein nahin, toh movies mein dekha hoga, Titanic mein, you all must have seen that huge iceberg. Now, iceberg may, what happens, you are only able to see the tip of the iceberg, which is only 10%. Rest 90% is under the water, right? So what I'm trying to say is that in a personality, it is the same form of a, like an iceberg. What you see about in a person is only 10%. The words that the person used, the tone that he or she has, the body language of that person, the presentation, the dressing up, all this is what you see in a person. That's only 10%. What you don't see about the person is the 90% which they have hidden from you, which is the beliefs of the person, the values, the prejudices, the experiences, their fears, their dreams, their feelings. These are below the surface here. And that's why you're not able to see that about the person. But the truth of the matter is, what the person doesn't show us, what is deep down inside, is what actually comes forward, which is actually what you see later on in life. All the deep structure below what you can see, beliefs, values, their experiences, their fears, etc. All this is what is shaping a personality of the person. So when you see a leader person, a good personality, for example, Suvrat, you said you look up to Ratan Tata, right? So what you see about him is, yes, you like the way he carries himself, the way he sits, the way he talks, the way his body language is. Ye aap dekh sakte hai. But you don't know the kind of work which has happened deep down, the challenges that he might have had to face, the fears that he might have, you know, had in him, the values, the beliefs. So what you don't see about a person is what they don't want to show you. But what you see is the 10% of the iceberg about that person, the way the person carries himself. And that is what is personality. Okay, that is what is the personality that you see about them, but you don't see the kind of work which is actually happening down below. Make sense? Everybody?
Yes.
Okay, great. Thanks. So what shapes a personality, as we were talking about a little while back, the genetic influences. Sometimes you get a personality from your parents also, you know, how they are, you end up like that. Yes. So genetics play a very important role. Your environment that you've been brought up in, your school, your you know, immediate school, your immediate family members, these are your environment when you were growing up, your friends, right? So that also helps you to shape your personality, and the cultural influences, whichever country you have or whichever continent you have been brought up in, the kind of culture of people around you, all those things have helped to shape your personality. But I'm going to repeat myself once again, your personality is not ki ek bar ho gaya and that is the rest of your life. No, you can keep working on your personality. You can start polishing your personality like how you would polish a diamond, right? And that is what is very important, the work that you do within you, the work that has to happen within you to get you to that level of having a great personality. Okay, so now what we are going to do is how you can enhance your personality. What are the ways in which you can work on your personality? Don't compare your life to other people. What we do most of the time is, this one is so much better than me. This one has so much more money than me. This one is so much more successful than me. So don't compare your life, because if you start comparing yourself to other people, it shows that you have less self-esteem. You have less of confidence in yourself. Okay. Don't have negative thoughts or things that you cannot control. All of us go through the challenging times of the pandemic right now, where we are forced to be at home. We have not able, you know, school, college life has got affected. Our finances have got affected. Relationships at home has got affected. So all these are negative things which you cannot control, but you need to start thinking in a positive manner. Okay. Don't waste your precious energy on gossip and things about you, which you cannot do anything about. And dream more while you are awake. Have goals. Yes. We'll come to that in a little while from now. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to put you into breakout room. I'm going to give you a topic. Okay. And you have to discuss with your team members on that particular topic and write down notes, write down your points. Okay. And then after 10 minutes, I will get you back on the main room and then we will share those points with everyone. Okay. Great. Let's do that. What you have to discuss about, I'm going to put it into the chat box. In your breakout room, I want you to discuss on ways to make people like you. Okay. So this is what you have. This is the topic which you are going to discuss with your team members in your breakout room. And after 10 minutes, you will come back on the main session and we are going to discuss on these points. Is it okay with everyone? All good? Okay.
Yes.
So you can include as many points as you want, but I want at least a minimum of 7-8 points. You can go higher also. You can go as many points as you want, but it has to be related to the topic, ways to make people like you. Okay. So I'm putting you into breakout room right now. And here we go. I'm putting two of you all in one room, okay, and the remaining two in the other room. Just give me some time to get this done. Okay, 10 minutes is what you have, and your time starts now. Umang, my dear, you have to join room 2 with Mayuri. Umang, please go and join room number 2. Okay? Manveer, can you just check with Umang? I think he's, has he left the meeting? Because I cannot see him in the breakout room. Manveer, just check whether Umang
is there. Well, yeah, she's not in the meeting right now. Maybe she got disconnect. I'll just check her.
Yeah, just check on her because I can't see her. And also just check on Mayuri. I'm not able to, I don't know whether she can hear or what, because when I joined the breakout room, she was not responding at all. Just check on her also once, please.
All right.
Thank you. All right. I think everyone has come back into the main room. Bhargav, Suvrat, you're here. Mayuri is here. And okay. All right. So let's quickly discuss the points which you all have discussed in your breakout room. Suvrat and Bhargav, would you all like to discuss your points first?
Yeah, sure. Okay, so basically we've rounded out 10 points in a way that a person would like you. First impression is important, as we mentioned, discussed earlier. Then the nature should be caring and empathizing, and being nice to people, and having knowledge from different fields, being knowledgeable, being soft-spoken, talking the problem out with the other person, positive attitude and approach, and staying down to earth and calm, standing for the right thing, and giving priority to your loved ones and important people.
Okay, fantastic. Good points, Bhargav and Subrat, both of you. And I hope both of you discussed the points and then wrote it down together, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. All right, thank you. Let's go to the second breakout room in which we had Mayuri and Umang, who I don't know why she's not with us right now. She's left the meeting. But Mayuri, would you like to discuss your points? If you can't unmute yourself, you can probably just use the chat box and tell us what are your what did you all discuss about? Ways to make people like you. What are your points? Put it into the chat box, please. Okay. Okay. Umang, I believe you are back again in the room, in the meeting. Okay, so the points that you all have discussed, Subrat and Mayu and Bhargav, I think very, very valid points. And by the time I'm waiting for the rest of them also to put into the chat box, let me quickly share what I have, my thoughts on how to make people, ways to make people like you. Okay, so I'm sharing my screen right now. Okay, so some of the points may be repetitive, but moreover, these are what is how to make people like you or how to have a good personality. So becoming genuinely interested in other people, I think this is one quality which is really missing in people nowadays, because everyone's so busy with their own things going on. But being genuinely interested in other people, is something that really makes people like you, because very rarely do we come across people who are interested in what you're doing or who are interested in, what's happening in your life, right? So becoming genuinely interested in other people is one way to make people like you. Also smiling, I think that's a given thing. You have to, if you smile a lot, automatically you draw people towards you, right? So some people are very kharoos by nature. They never smile, okay? They have this frown on their face always. So I think it's a great icebreaker to smile at people and to smile often, okay? Being a good listener, talking less and listening more is something, again, which is a way to develop your personality. Genuinely start listening to other people when they're sharing things with you, rather than being distracted with technology, with your mobile phones, with your iPads, etc. Try to just leave everything and listen to people when they're sharing something with you. Encourage other people to talk about themselves. I think this is, again, something which really helps you be more likable. When you tell others to talk about themselves, rather than you going on talking and hogging the limelight, I think it's very essential that be interested in other people's life and help them or encourage them to talk about themselves. You will not believe this is such a killer, because the more people, you know, I mean, everybody likes to talk, but not many are given the chance, right, to talk. So encourage them to talk about themselves. Show respect for other people's opinions. Sabke apne apne opinion hai. Everybody has their own mindset, their own perspective about things. You don't have to, love them or hate them. Just accept them the way they are. I think Umang is trying to join the session again. Okay. So respect other people's opinions. I think that's very, very essential. Even if you have your own opinion, like that, people also have their own opinion. So accept it. Never say you're wrong. Nobody likes listening to this criticism, you know, this word that, oh, you're wrong about this. There's a better way to put it. Okay. I hope you all are writing down these points because it's very important. Okay. Tomorrow, once the course is over, you'll forget all about it. So once you have the points written down, you will be able to come back to it whenever you feel like, okay? So don't say you're wrong. Say it in a polite manner, rather. If you are wrong, admit it quickly and empathetically. What is empathetic? Today, this is one quality which really helps you be more likable to people. Empathy is putting yourself into other people's shoes, okay? Thinking from their point of view. Being more caring, that's empathy. Empathy is different from sympathy, okay? So empathy is very essential in today's life when you are able to empathize with other people. Put yourself into their shoes, okay? Begin in a friendly way. People like being around those people who like to talk in a friendly way, okay? So that's again something that can make you more likable. Try honestly to see things from other people's point of view. See, as I mentioned earlier, everybody has their own personality. Everybody has their own perspective or way of looking at things. What you can do to be more likable is try to see things from other person's point of view. Okay, that's again very important. Now, how to have a good personality? Don't be loud. Nobody likes people who are all the time loud and talking in a very loud manner. It's not having good etiquette. Okay, it's not having good manners. Agar aap bahut zyada zor zor se chilla chilla ke baat karte, it's not a good thing to have a good, you know, in a person who has a good personality. Now imagine this. Okay, I'm just going to halt over here and spend some time over here. Suppose a CEO of the company, MD of the company, at that leadership level, director of a company, for example, okay? He's at such a senior position in his organization, right? The MD, the CEO of the company. And imagine you see him screaming at a peon in the office. Yeah, that's such a negative impression that you would have about some person like that. Imagine the kind of hierarchy, the kind of status, the kind of position that person has, you know, such a hierarchy, you know, he's at such a top level. But if you see him being angry and shouting at a peon of a company, of the office, imagine what kind of a bad impression you would have, right? So don't be loud. Nobody likes people who are loud all the time. Also, know when to speak up. Not every time is a good time to speak up, right? So know when you have to draw that line. Don't be afraid to talk to others. I think this is something which a lot of us have this fear ki, you know, you will rather be quiet rather than talk to others. You know, what's the number one fear today? The number one fear is not the fear of dying. The number one fear is talking to people. Okay? Giving a presentation in front of hundreds of people. That's a fear which many, many people have. And I have conducted more than 100 workshops on presentation skills. More than 100. And this is something which every participant in my training program tells me that, ma'am, I have a fear of speaking in front of people. How do I overcome that? So this is some, if you have learned how to overcome that fear of talking to other people, that's again something which will help you to be having a good personality. So don't be afraid. Okay. Having a sense of humor is a plus point. How many of us would like to be around people who are cribbing and complaining? And how many of us would like to be around people who have a good sense of humor and who make us laugh? What do you say to that? Bhargav, whom would you like to be around? Somebody who's cribbing and complaining or somebody who has a good sense of humor?
No, people with sense of humor.
Absolutely. What about you, Suvrat?
Somebody who cracks me up.
Yes, absolutely. And how about you, Mayuri and Umang? Put it in the chat box. I believe both of you have some network issues or something like that. So just put it in the chat box. So humor is something which really makes you more likable as a person. And you know, you have a good personality. If you have, you are able to crack jokes, you know, if you are able to have a, you know, these good one-liners, these punchlines, people like all that, you know, there's enough stress around us any which ways. So it's nice to be around people who have a good humor. Okay. Remember, personality doesn't mean that you should have the looks. It's not just that if you are good looking, handsome looking, you have a good personality. Personality is just not about looks. It's also about who you are as a person from within, how caring you are, how much you like to help others, you know, how much etiquette and manners you have. Imagine you see a very nice looking boy or a girl and you feel, wow, he or she has such a great personality. But the moment they open their mouth, foul words come out and they are always criticizing, complaining and shouting at others. Do you think that person would have a good personality? Yes or no?
No.
So it is not just ki you look nice. No, personality is not only about that. You need to have a good heart from within. I think that's very important. Okay. Be kind and considerate. Very important in today. If you want to have good personality, be kind towards people. Be considerate towards other people. That's what somebody has a good personality has. A kind-hearted person. Keep a smart head and keep cool. People who have good personality, they don't crack under pressure. Okay, they learn how to keep their calm and composure. That's what a good personality is. Not people who crack up under pressure. Oh my God, such a stress, such a situation, and they just leave, you know, lose out on their composure. That's not somebody who has a good personality. Don't shout or be aggressive. That's not somebody who has a good personality does. Okay, don't doubt yourself. That's again very important. You know, these doubts that we keep having in our mind, I'm not good enough, I'm not smart enough, I don't have good communication skills. These are all negative self-talk. Okay, so if you want to rise and shine and have a good personality, you need to break this self-doubt. You need to stop this constant negative self-doubting which happens, which all of us go through, you know. So you need to stop doubting yourself and believe in yourself. That's very, very important. I'm just going to take a minute here and read the chat box also. Okay. Yes, Umang. So one should be benevolent in his actions, should not be biased towards people and treat everyone nicely. Very good point, Umang. Thanks for sharing that. All right. So moving on with a few more points on how to have a good personality is be executive in dress, which means you need to be well-dressed. Okay. People who have good personality are people who are always well-dressed, whether you see them at home, whether you see them outside, they always have that good self-image. See, imagine a situation. I'm sharing this with everyone. This happened with me a couple of years back. So I had, once you're out of home for buying few things here and there, you tend to go in your home clothes, right? You don't really dress up well to go get some bread and eggs from a Kirana store, right? So I happened to do that and I met one of my office person, a colleague of mine in that shop where I was buying things from. And suddenly I felt very conscious about what I was wearing because I was not dressed well. I was just, you know, in my home clothes. So, you know, I felt conscious and I felt very, I didn't want to go and say hello to the colleague because of the fact that I knew that I was not dressed well and I did not, you know, I mean, it was just very, I felt I didn't have that confidence to go and speak to my colleague, office colleagues, right? So what I'm trying to say over here is your personality, the way you're dressed up can also be, have an impact about the way you think people will think about you. And that lowers your confidence. Okay. So you need to be dressed well because people who have great personality are people who are comfortable in their own attire, in what they're wearing, and they're at comfort level with their personality. Okay. Yes, Mayuri, your dressing sense reflects your personality, your character, your mood, style, and what you actually you are as an individual. Very good. Very, very valid point, Mayuri. Thanks for sharing that. Yes. So that is what is important. A good personality is all of these things. Create your own personal style. Don't copy anyone. Okay. Just because you like a particular personality doesn't mean that you have to ape that person. No, because everyone has their own individual personality. God has made all of us unique, right? So we need to be true to ourselves and don't impersonate somebody. Don't try to be somebody like that person, because then you'll end up looking like a fool. Okay. So have your own personal style, have your own branding, have your own personality, and don't copy from people here and there. Okay. So were these points good? What do you all say? Was this informative?
Yes, very much.
Yes. Okay. I hope you all have also written down these points. If not, just take a screenshot of the same so that you can, you know, go back to these notes later also. Okay. Fantastic. Yes. Umang says one should not belittle others. Very good point, Umang. You need to respect other people and not put them down in any manner. That's again a very bad, trait, and you cannot have a good personality if you are always, nagging at people or, putting people down. So respect each other, treat people like how you would want to be treated, right? That's very important. Now, coming to why we are discussing all this is, whichever field or whichever industry you want to go into, whether it's aviation, whether it's any other industry, having a good personality is something which is important in any field and any industry. Okay, aisa nahi hai ki aviation mein hi aapko jana hai, aage future banana hai, so then only personality is important. No, it's not that. Personality is something which will help you, and developing your personality is something which will help you in any area, any field of your life. Even if you want to start your own business, it's something that will help you in your meetings, in your meetings with your prospects or business people, whatever it is. So having a good personality is something which will help you any which way. So that's why we are understanding how to improve and enhance your personality. Now, whatever points we have discussed, aisa nahi hai ki, these are the things that, just one second. Okay. Whatever points we have discussed, aisa nahi hai ki this is a limited list. There are more things that you can add over here. It's not just that limited to this only. So if you want to have a great personality, what are the points that we have learned right now? Can anyone quickly tell me 4 or 5 things which you have learned about how you can have a good personality? Bhargav? I'm not expecting you to remember all, but just 4 or 5 things which you feel are on top of your mind to have a good personality. Sorry. Yes, Bhargav. Bhargav, we are not able to hear you again. You're on mute. Unmute yourself. Okay, I think he's facing some challenge. No worries. Subrat, can you tell me your top 5 things that you remember of how you have a good personality or how you can have a great personality? Bhargav, you can probably put down your points in the chat box.
Okay. So number 1, be respectful to others.
Mm-hmm.
Number 2, have an empathizing nature. Number 3, always dress up sensibly.
Very good.
Number 4, what can we say? Always have a positive approach towards things.
Very good.
And number 5, always do not burst yourself out in stressful situations. Stay calm and stay down to earth.
Good. Very nice. Thank you for sharing that, Subrat. And Umang has shared her points. So idealized people, do not copy them. Good. Benevolence, empathetic, soft-spoken. Yes, good dressing sense. You have already mentioned that. Fantastic. Bhargav, you can put your points also in the chat box. Okay, so now I want you to think about any 3 top challenges that you have with regards to whatever points we have done right now. Whether it's a dressing sense, having a good dressing sense, or whether it's having an empathetic nature is a challenge to you, being kind towards other, or not being a good listener. Jo bhi humne points, we have spoken about, any 3 top challenges that you feel are something which is a concern for you individually, I'm talking about, okay? For example, if Mayuri, you feel ki I am not somebody who's a good listener and I want to work on this, so that could be your one challenge, okay? Bhargav, if you feel that for you it's not having a good not being genuine towards other people, or not having empathetic towards other people, that's a challenge for you, then write that down, okay? So for all of you, your top three challenges which you feel are something which you really need to work on, please jot it down in your notepad and pen. On your notepad, jot down any three challenges which are coming in the way of you having a good personality. It could be not being able to have good listening. It can be not having a positive attitude. It can be not being anything, whatever. Okay? Take 2 minutes and write down these three challenges. Let me know if you all are done. Put it in the chat box, done, if you have finished doing this. Okay. So Suvrat, since you have done this, can you quickly tell us your top three challenges?
Sometimes I fear public speaking.
Okay.
And sometimes I go through performance pressure.
Whenever
whenever I have to deliver something.
Mm-hmm.
And third one is a disciplined routine. I have a very scattered kind of lifestyle.
Okay. All right, great. So you feel these are the three challenges which are stopping you from actually shining and giving your best, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what I want you to do, Suvrat, is now I would want you to start working on these three challenges individually. Start having a plan of how you can overcome these challenges. And that is something you can, devise a plan for yourself. Okay, if it's fear of public speaking, what can you do about it? Okay, so top three goals for you with regards to fear of public speaking, ko kaise aap hata sakte hain, kaise you can overcome that fear. Okay, so performance pressure, whenever you are under a spotlight and you have to deliver and you are not able to, what are the three things you can do about it to overcome that particular performance pressure? So like that, I want you to devise your three action plans for all these three challenges, right? Can we do that?
Yes, sure.
All right, thank you. Over to you, Bhargav. What are your three top challenges?
I just like afraid to talk. I like don't dare to, and also like right now not living in the present, thinks always about the future and then worries. And also with if anything goes wrong, I will just change my whole day, spoil my mood.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Thanks for sharing that, Bhargav. And it takes a lot of courage to say all these things publicly. So I appreciate all of you for sharing all this with me, really. Okay, it's not easy. So thanks for sharing that, Bhargav. Again, like I said to Suvrat, I want you to work on the action plan for these fears, like fear of public speaking. If something goes wrong in your day, it spoils your whole mood. So what can you do about it? So write down an action plan that number one, number two, number three, these are the things I can do to take control of my day. Rather than the day controlling me, I control my day, right? So you have to write down this action plan for yourself, okay? So take today's day and do this homework. Okay. Mayuri, you have put it in the chat box, fear of public speaking. Okay. Nervousness to paralyzing fear and panic. I can understand, completely relate to that, because once when I started training, you know, I had 5 participants in my training and I could not open my mouth to speak. No words were coming out. I was so scared. So it's completely understandable. Again, you have to start working on your action plan. Mayuri, what you can do to overcome these challenges. Okay. I hope it's clear for everyone. Okay.
Yes.
Moving on. I want to share something with you over here, which is called as, can you all see my screen? Okay, SWOT analysis. Now, what is SWOT? SWOT stands for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Do we know what this is? Anybody? Have you all heard about SWOT before?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Okay, so what I want you to do now is take 5 minutes and tell me what is your SWOT. Okay, this is an individual exercise, not a team exercise. What are your strengths? Any top 2 or 3 strengths of yours? Any top 3 weaknesses of yours? Any opportunities which you feel are there currently, which you want to harness? And what are the threats which you are undergoing right now? Okay. Threat means from the environment point of view or your personality point of view, whatever it is. So take about 5 minutes and I want you to spend this 5 minutes on your SWOT. Okay. So let's do this right away. I'm going to give you 5 minutes. Okay. Okay, I hope everyone has finished what I have asked you all to do, SWOT analysis. Yes. Just reading the chat box. Okay, so 1 minute. Okay. Whatever is your SWOT, your strengths, your weaknesses, your opportunities, and your threats, my only request to all of you over here is that whatever are your strengths, these are your, it's your talent, okay? And you should always work on your strengths. While it's important to know what your weaknesses are, don't spend too much time on your weaknesses, okay? For the simple reason that whatever is your strength area, that's something that will help you rise and shine more, okay? But weaknesses, if you spend too much time on your weaknesses, you're not able to do justice to yourself, okay? Because you're spending your time on the wrong thing, okay? But here again, it's a important thing to understand. For example, if your weakness is public speaking, you definitely have to work on that. You can't, overrule it, right? Because today, speaking in front of public or presentation skills is something that is very, very crucial and important. And you have to know that, because whichever field you are in or whenever you're going for an interview, also the way you present yourself to your interviewers is something which will help you crack that interview. Okay. So having a good sense of, your strengths is good, but spend more time on your strengths rather than on your weaknesses. Okay, that's something which will help you have a better and a great energetic personality. Now, there's one more thing which I did not mention while I was talking about ways to have a good personality, and that's a very crucial thing. Having being an energetic and an enthusiastic person. Okay. That point I somehow missed out, which I wanted to share with all of you over here. If you are somebody who has that energy within you and that enthusiasm when you talk to people, it's very contagious, right? Energy is contagious. If you are smiling, happy, and enthusiastic all the time, you will attract a lot of people towards you. People like being around people who are enthusiastic and energetic. Okay. So that's one thing which helps you to have a great personality. If you're dull and if you're boring in your way of speaking, nobody would want to listen to you, right? Am I making sense or am I talking nonsense?
No, ma'am, you're perfectly making sense.
Thank you, Subrat. Yes. So it's very important to have a good energy, and that's something which helps you have a great personality is when you have that enthusiasm and energy when you speak to other people. Okay. You may be having a lot of knowledge, but if you don't know how to put it into words properly and communicate it properly, that's again something which will be not helping you having a great personality. Okay. Now I'm not going to ask you all to share your SWOT with me. It's something for you. It's your own personal thing. But what I would highly recommend is that when you have identified your strengths, your three top strengths, make sure that you're working on your strengths more and more. Okay. So that's very, very important. Okay. If you're somebody who likes to be around people and that's your strength and you like to talk to people, then use it to your advantage. Okay. Don't get a job into a back end where you'll not be able to, do justice to your strength. Okay. Got it? All right. So what I'm going to do now is we are almost towards the end of our session. I want to check with you if you have any questions, any doubt from our session today. I'm also going to be giving you a small assignment. Okay. I hope you are okay with that. You have to be okay with that. You don't have a choice, actually. Okay. All right. So any questions for today on our session? How did you like the session, not like the session? Did you feel it value added to you? Do you think it gave you any insight into personality and soft skills? We'll still talk about, we have more days, but any questions for me?
Yes, ma'am, I have a query.
Please go ahead.
Actually, that you mentioned earlier that in order to enhance our personality, we need to know ourselves firstly. So what are some quick ways or what are some ways in which we can get an insight of ourselves in a better way?
Very nice question, Subrat. So knowing yourself is very important, because only if you know yourself will you be able to put on a better version of yourself for other people. Okay, so ways to know yourself better is, firstly, spend a lot of time with yourself. Okay, which I mean, spend time minus the technology, minus any distraction. Probably be in an area of your home or in your room or wherever where there are no distractions, when there are no where there's no one to talk to and you are just by yourself. Okay, when you are by yourself, try to observe your thoughts. Okay, introspect on your day, morning and night. Just spend about 15-20 minutes with yourself and try to understand yourself better. Try to know what are your thoughts. Observe yourself, observe your thoughts. Where are they coming from? Okay. A lot of us, what we feel is, sometimes we feel we have lack of confidence. We have low self-esteem. Understand, where is that coming from? What are the thoughts which are giving way to those negative self-talk or whatever it is? Okay. See, I think the most important thing, Suvrat, is just spending time with yourself. I think it's very crucial, because in our day-to-day life, we don't actually have the time to sit with ourselves for even 5 minutes. We are always so busy doing something or the other. When are we actually spending time with ourselves? Hardly. You know, so my only one tip over here, or suggestion over here, to really know yourself, you need to spend time with yourself. Spend time with your thoughts. Meditate on yourself, you know. Just try to be thoughtless for a little while. Try just to be still. Okay. When you are still, you start knowing yourself more and more, how you are acting, how you're behaving with others, a bit about yourself. That's something which will help you. Okay. It has helped me over the couple of years, and that's the reason I'm sharing this advice with you. Okay. So spend time with yourself to know yourself better.
Thank you.
I hope that helped.
Yeah, surely. Basically, we have to see ourselves from a third person perspective.
See yourself from, as if you are observing yourself from outside of you. Okay. Like, as if you are dead and you are a spirit who's observing you. I'm sorry to use that like that, but I hope it's just a hypothetical way of explaining, like, just think of yourself that you're having an out of body experience. You understand that, right? So,
yes.
Yeah. So try to observe yourself from that point of view, how you are as a person. That just spend time with yourself for that, minus technology, minus anything which is distracting, because today our mobile phones are our number one distractions. One ping, one notification on Facebook, on Insta, on whatever, it just takes away all our attention towards that thing, right? So try to be minus the technology for at least 1 hour every day. Okay,
thank you.
Thank you. All right. So it's, I hope Bhargav, Mayuri, Umang, no questions from your end. I hope you all liked the session. Please put it in the chat box, your feedback about, do you feel the pace of the session is all right? Do you feel I'm going fast, slow, whatever it is, just put it into the chat box. I'll be very, very happy to receive, anything which I feel I need to improve on. Okay. I'm sharing the homework with you all. So one homework, I've already given you, right? Something to do. What was that? I forgot.
I'm working on our three challenges.
Yes, your three challenges, which are helping, which are stopping you, or are obstacles or barriers which are getting in the way of you developing your personality, right? That's the number one homework. The second homework I'm sharing with you all over here, I want you all to quickly take a screenshot of this. Just a second. So every day we're going to be giving you assignments and homework. Okay. And I'm expecting all of you to do that for the next day. No excuses at all. Okay. Can you all see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Please take a picture of this. 1 second. Let me just bold it a little bit. Yeah. There are 10 questions which I want you to spend time with, these questions which will help you to know yourself better, as Suvrat, you were asking me a little while back also. So these questions will help you to analyze, think deep down about yourself and how you are actually. Okay. So please take a screenshot of this, take a picture of this, and start working on these 10 questions. Tomorrow when we meet for the class again, I will be asking you these. Okay. So please make sure you have finished it. Okay. What I will also be doing is I'll be sharing my email ID after in the chat box right now. I want you all to send me your answers in the email once you are done by the end of the day today. Okay. So I'm sharing my... okay, I need to stop sharing. Have you all taken the picture of this? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I'm putting my email ID in the chat box. Please send me your answers. I mean, send me your sheet with the answers on this email ID. Okay? Got it, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm going to see you all tomorrow for the class. Please log in on time today. People who are late, I would request you all to be on time tomorrow. There are a lot of things which we are going to cover tomorrow. Very important things, and I don't want you to miss out. Clear? All right.
Yes,
thank you, ma'am. Everyone, for your time. I will want you all to have more energy in our class tomorrow.
Ma'am, please mention your mail.
Sorry?